Housing First is part of a solution to end rough sleeping and long-term homelessness. If you're at risk of homelessness, you can ask your local authority or council for help. Sometimes, however, the pressure of traumatic experiences, life events, and issues such as poverty can build up and overwhelm people. That makes it really important that we get involved and help people to find housing and support immediately. This is called rapid rehousing. It means that people who need a home are helped very quickly to find one. But what about people who've developed really complicated issues? That's where Housing First comes in. For people facing many different and complicated challenges, Housing First is an effective response. It works by placing someone in a property of their choice with their own tenancy, and then support is put in place that is flexible, responsive, and crucially, that has no time limit. Housing First works most effectively with people who tend to experience issues with substance use and mental health, and are described as having complex needs. Housing First has been researched across the world. It works, but it is really important that key principles are followed. If these are not followed, it isn't Housing First. This doesn't mean it isn't effective support, but it's not the Housing First approach. In Wales, we have split these principles into 10 easy points to follow. People have a right to a home that is affordable, secure, habitable, and with availability of services. This means that Housing First is based on the rights that we all have. Housing and support are separated. It is really important that housing services and support are separate. This means that collection of rent, maintenance, and any official housing business is done by very different professionals than the support. The support is there to help the tenant, and that needs to be their primary focus at all times. The service is targeted at people who demonstrate a repeat pattern of failing to maintain hostel accommodation and/or people rough sleeping or accessing emergency accommodation. Housing First is for people who need a high level of support. It isn't for everyone, but it is incredibly effective for the group that it targets. Flexible support is provided for as long as it is needed. Support around the person needs to be flexible and based on what they want and need. And again, it has no time limit. An active engagement approach is used. We call this assertive outreach. People delivering Housing First should never give up on people. Finding the right way to work with people is crucial. Individuals have choice and control. People who are being supported by Housing First need to have a choice and control over their lives. They decide where they want to live, whether they want to be somewhere closer to family, future employment, and leisure. They can ask to go wherever there is housing available and wherever helps them remain happy. A harm reduction approach is used. Some people supported through Housing First may need help with drugs or alcohol. The key point is that they aren't forced to get help until they are ready. The service is delivered in a psychologically informed, trauma-informed, gender-informed way that is sensitive and aware of protected characteristics. Everyone is different. Some of us have varied needs. The key point is that any Housing First service needs to be sensitive to those needs. The service is based on people's strengths, goals, and aspirations, and as such has an explicit commitment to a small caseload. Housing First works, but it is also intensive. As such, in order to provide a personalised, focused, and flexible service, support workers need to have a very small caseload, working with between 7 to 9 people at any one time. Any more than that, and there is a risk that the very focused approach, tailored to people's needs, is diluted. The widest range of public services are involved from the outset. The most successful Housing First schemes are those where other services are fully involved. So the NHS, social services, police, all need to be working closely with the service from day one. We know that when the principles are followed and when Housing First is targeted at those who need it the most, it can have an extremely positive impact. Typically, around 80% of people housed through Housing First remain in successful tenancies. This is incredible, and all of us across Wales have a chance to get involved and make this a success.